Asian markets came under more pressure on Wednesday, dented by hawkish comments from the Fed, with Governor Lyle Brainard signaling a swift cut in debt holdings as early as May over and above rate hikes. This on top of a looming second round of sanctions on Russia for its invasion of Ukraine. MUFG Bank Sophia Nang expects risk sentiment to remain quite shaky, expecting to continue to see outflows from Asian markets.
Depending on the size of the outflows, it depends. The impact on certain currencies will be different. For example, if we look at the Indian rupee, in the first 3 months of this year, the amount of outflows from the equity markets is actually very massive. In the first 3 months alone, it's about $15 billion worth of outflows. So that is even bigger than the annual outflows that we have seen during the pandemic, the start of the pandemic in 2020, as well as the global financial crisis in 2008. And actually differentiate between the type of currencies, for example, those that are more related to oil, more oil-sensitive currencies like the Philippine peso and the Indian rupee, I would say they would actually be more vulnerable.
Nang adds, at this point, it appears the Philippine Central Bank's hands are tied, caught between rising inflation and the need to support economic recovery, which a rate hike could choke. For the day, the PSE index lost nearly 0.75% to settle just a touch above 7,100 on the back of nearly half a billion pesos in net foreign selling. First Metro Securities' Aaron Tsai sees no major shift in the local market for now.
Volume has really been flat and below average. No, well, we saw trading. We extended trading to the afternoon, but volume has really been below average. No, again, I think the market is in a wait and see mode. No, there are a lot of macro factors that could affect fund flows and valuation. I think I even see some broker already downgrading their call for the market, no, due to higher yields. But for now, with next week's shortened trading week, and also in consideration, I think investors might be spending their time watching on the sidelines.
In corporate stories, SM Prime will open its newest mall in the country in Rojas City, Capiz, this Friday, adding 41,000 square meters of gross floor area, 81% of space lease already awarded. Meanwhile, Century Tuna and birch tree maker Century Pacific Foods posted a 20% jump in full-year net income for 2021 to 4.7 billion pesos as revenues grew 13%, thanks to strong OEM exports and resilient local demand as people bought more healthy products. This despite a high base effect from its strong performance in 2020. The even better news, first quarter 2022 revenue growth already at high single digits. As expected though, margins dropped by 1.4% due to higher input costs globally. The PoLed company notes it also benefited from favorable tax rates thanks to the CREATE bill allowing it to reinvest. The company in December announced it's buying Ligo Sardines, a deal expected to close by June. And finally, ASEAN developer DMW CEO Buds Wenceslao bullish about the prospects for the property market this year, mainly driven by improved mobility that's expected to boost office market demand by 20%, while the residential side of the business saw low cancellations. Wenceslao notes they were able to hedge against inflation and a REIT IPO could still be a while.
We are a prime candidate for that just because almost 60% of our revenue streams are from recurring income. But yeah, you know, it's a question of funding timing. Right now, we still have a substantial amount or percentage of our credit lines still on tap. And we still have about 10% of our IPO funds still in our war chest. So we're actually going to deploy those. Right now, we have about also another 80,000 square meters of leasable area that's still under construction. It's supposed to finish by 2022. So we want to ramp up all of these projects development pipeline before we start considering going to a REIT. For the company itself, for our two major projects, we were able to lock in most of the major materials pre-pandemic, basically steel, cement, glass, aluminum, electrical components. So that's a big factor for us. But yes, we do foresee that, and we are seeing an increase in price, especially since over the last 2 years. And you know, with the geopolitical events happening.
Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.